Okay. Hello, this is Double Talk 73. We're in Louisiana, and we're going to try this Catfish Trail event. I haven't done very good in it before, but we'll see what happens. I had to put my kayak and my rod holder in the home storage because they won't let me use it, so let's see what we can do here. Okay, go fishing. We're going to land over here at the hut. Okay, we're going to walk out this walkway. We're not raining. I like it when it's raining. Am I at the right one? Yeah, looks pretty good. Okay, let's see what we can do. Let's see. Let me show you what my rig is. Just lose a little fishing time here. I'm using my Brutus 910 Thunderspin 4500 02 35 mass set, Glomar 50 hook large cut, and we got a bobber set at 69 inches large cut. We'll start off with large cut, and if we don't catch anything with it, I swap to frogs. I like both large cut and frogs, so let's see if we can get 59 feet out here and see what happens. I know one thing, we get hung up here a lot. That's the bad thing about where we have to fish for these things. Okay, I wish it was raining. The flatheads bite a whole lot better when it's raining. Well, at least we're at 5 o'clock in the morning. That's a good start. If it's raining good, they'll bite from 5 to 9 o'clock. You got 4 hours you can catch them. And during that 4 hour, you should get between 3 and 5 unis. If they want frogs today. That bobber laying on its side doesn't not necessarily mean you're not going to catch fish. But if I don't catch something here in the mirror, so I'm going to change locations. Here we go. Thank you. A ding is better than no ding. Give me a big uni. Something better than nothing. It's not a little fish. Okay. I'm not skunked. That's a definite plus. I have been in these events, just got totally skunked. I mean, that happens too. All you can do is try. You ain't gonna win if you don't try. If you don't try, you'll definitely lose. Maybe we'll get them rolling here in a minute now. there are some people know how what they call quick catch, and it depends on how the barber bounces and when it bounces. I ain't figured that out yet. Every time I tried, I just miss. But there are some people that are pretty good at it. So when the barber moves, they catch a fish. I gotta wait till they take it. Boy, that axe down here, that's a little bigger fish. Maybe a trophy if we're lucky. Yes, thank you. We'll take a trophy. We ain't setting the world on fire, but we ain't burning down either. Leaving 58. I ain't gonna dicker with it. And we moved up a little bit. We got a long ways to go. That's okay. Every journey starts with the first step. And each fishing trip starts with the first fish. Successful fishing trip. Come on, Uni. Come on, Uni. I don't usually fish for catfish down here. I usually fish for gar or bass or white crappie. That's what I like to fish for. But there's not one of those events right now. Now I know a fish is moving that bobber because that frog ain't going to swim. That looks like a channel if I had to hazard a guess. Yep, that's a trophy channel. That'll work. It's worth more points than a common. Sound like my wife might have just let my dog in. He coming down the stairs. Yeah, big old horse. Hey, buddy. Hey, buddy. He's a 140-pound Great Pyrenees. He's a baby in our family. Going to get him a haircut tomorrow. He looks like a big old woolly bear. Got a big old hair around his neck. Looks like a lion's mane. And long hair down his legs. Looks like he's got pantaloons on. Yeah, come here. Come here. Come here. Yeah. Yeah. Good boy. Been drinking that water. Yeah, whole mouth is wet. He likes to be rubbed under his neck and on his chest. Okay. He's our baby. The baby in the family. He got his nose under my arm when I'm trying to hold a space bar down to reel in. That's what I use for reeling. And trying to push my arm up so I'll pet him some more. Oh, me. What a dog. What a dog. What a dog. Yeah, what a dog. Yeah, and he's a sniffer, not a licker. I like that. I like that. Now you can see him. Yeah, you can see my puppy. Yeah. Big old boy. He's 3 years old, 140 pounds. And when he comes down those stairs, it sounds like a horse running through the house. Yeah. And he loves cashew nuts. He'd do anything for a cashew. He'd do that better than when a doggy treats. Go on. Go on. Let me fish. Puts his paw up, that means I want more. Give me more, give me more. Boy, somebody already got 2,500 points. Wow, they are catching some fish. We're going to catch one more here and then change locations. We go over where the gar is and change your rig to. Now you're going to wait. Time's a-wasting. Okay. We're going to get this. We're going to leave it. Let's see. Yeah, we'll leave it there. We're going to put a frog on there. We're going to get a 5-aught hook. Now we're going to use a 3-aught. 3-aught hook. And rod 2. Okay. We're going over here to Swampy Open. We're going to walk up here. We're going to cast this area right out here. See that limb hanging down? That's where I want to cast. About 2,530 feet out. Did I get it? Oh, Lord, no. I still got the wrong rod. Shame on me. I'm new at this game. I've been playing about a year and a half, but I'm new at this game. Here we go. About 125, 135. We'll leave it there. I wish the sinkers were heavier so they wouldn't move so easy. When you got large minnows on, the sinkers, man, that line will move around everywhere. Well, we just about the bottom of the heap. Just about the bottom of the heap of those that are fishing right now. We still got time, though. Pretty decent fish, I think. There we go. Thank you. I'm not too versed with using a bottom rod like this, so bear with me. Usually I use a bottom rod with rod stands. At least I'm not to the bottom. That was a good catch there. That's some good points. I can do that about 20 more times before the time runs out. Might have some. This is how I caught my uni channel cat. I was fishing on the bottom, but it's before we had bottom rods, and I had to figure out a way. So I used a small hook, bait, and a sport bobber. Yeah, that's work. That's points. And cast it out there, and the weight of the hook and the bait took it to the bottom. So that was a rigged up Texas rig. And it worked. I got my uni. Something bit on it. Let it go. Think I'm out of the hole. I think it's 25 to 35. Nope. There we go. That 3-aught hook is a, on here they call it an octopus hook. And here in the United States they call it a treble hook. Same thing, only different. Multiple hooks on a single. My wife wants to know if I need to fix supper. Phone down. Wow, 3,300 points. They're catching a bunch of unis. Practice, practice, practice. That's what it takes. Practice flats very often, so we'll see what happens. We still got bait, hook and bait in the water. Get out of here, Skeeter. There's a place somewhere over behind these trees over in here somewhere, but I don't know where it is. I've never fished there. Well, I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to go back over where we were before and fish on the bottom and see what we can do. Don't take as long to reel them in from over there either. If you wonder where this spot is, see that log right there? That's the just before that log, that stump sticking up at that angle, is where you walk out on that catwalk. Walk all the way out to the end, and you want to stand on the right corner. We want to be about 59 feet out. If we don't get hung up. Just text or she'll keep. Strike was done too early. That ain't what the bell said. The bell lied to me. They wouldn't do that, would they? Sure they would. Give it a little line, we can wash the line. Here it is. Nope. It's lying to me still. Okay. Let's change the large cut and see what happens here. that dog can be inside the house, sound asleep, and can hear a cat walking across the yard, across the street, and he'll wake up and go barking at it. Beats all I've ever seen. They were bred in Spain to herd llamas and sheep and cattle and horses, and they have a lot of wolf in them, and a wolf can hear the snap of a twig from over 2 miles away and can smell prey almost 3 miles away. That blows my mind. Here we go. It blows my mind. That is some sensitive faculties. See? Did you see the blue that time on there? That's supposed to be indication of a fish strike. Come on, game. Don't be mean to me. Besides the bell. Hey, way to go, Pro. Propensity's a buddy of mine. The one that's right now number one. He does a lot of research, a lot of experimenting, fishing everywhere. He's a pretty smart guy. Now, see? I didn't see a strike, did y'all? Heard the bells. They've been lying to me. I guess I'm supposed to jerk it every time I hear the bells. Ding dong, ding dong. Put another frog on there. And it looks like a channel. Or a small flat. Or a big channel. That's points. We ain't setting the world on fire, but it's points. I guess the main thing I'm showing you right now is where. Because I sure ain't showing you when and how. I'll have to come back down here on a regular video when it's a rainy morning. Now, every cloudy morning in Louisiana in a regular game is raining. So from 5 to 7, it's raining and you'll catch more fish, more flatheads. When the rain stops, they keep on biting for another 2 hours, but they're not as prolific. That's a bigger fish. That's at least a trophy. Wouldn't hurt my feelings fishing any, but it's at least a trophy. There we go. That's some good points. lucky. That's funny. I went to college in Middle Tennessee with this boy's name was David Swindle. He was from Mississippi, and his daddy owned a loan company. And honest to goodness, the name of his loan company was Swindle Loans. Oh, who'd have thunk it? Okay, let's put a frog back on there. Ooh, that's way too much. That'll get us hung up. Yeah, I thought so. There we go. Thank you. I get overeager. Sometimes I cast too weak. Sometimes I cast too strong. Oh, Pro, he pulled ahead of you by 400 points. Come on, man. Okay, we'll go back over to that other spot now. There's some people that believe in catch and move, catch and move. Bird sound. Chucky Derns. Dead under that. Okay, come on now, fish. The bells told me. This told me. No fish. That looks like a good place. Everybody films all these events when they place a top 1, 2, 3, top 10. I was looking at a guy's different stats, and there's a guy that's been fishing here a long time, fishing 2,000 and 3,000 of these events, and top 10 or top 1, 2, 3 is like 4 or 5. So the percentage of winding up high up in one of these events is against you, because there's so many people get out here and practice. One fish is one thing, and they're hard to beat. one time. I think I've entered 200 events. One time I got a third place. That was in Muskie Topping. And what it is you try to catch a fish as close as you can to 13 pounds. Or 6 kilograms, I think it is. It's the same thing. And I caught one with 12.8 something. Anyhow, came in third place. Just plum, pure old luck. Got nothing to do with skill. It's just throwing a crankbait out there. A frog popper. And seeing what you get. So if you know where they are, you'll get a fish. And one buddy of mine he's a pretty good fisherman. And he was in the event. And all he could catch was trophies and unis. He said, now how come I can't do this when I'm just fishing? He didn't catch a single common. Every single fish he caught was a trophy or a uni. He was happy about that, but he was sad that he didn't do anything in the event. But he places high in several of the events because he decides what events he wants to be good at. And then he practices just those fish. And I like to catch a little bit of everything. I like blues and muskies mainly, and gar. And I have videos on the muskies and the gar and the catfish in Michigan. We can try a catfish here in just a minute if we don't get something going here again. Although they score low. They don't score as high as flats. Okay, let's put another large cut on there. Those are two baits I know what. Let's try a medium cut. Let's just try something different. We're not setting the world on fire, actually, are we? So let's try a medium cut, just to see. It's not like we've got anything to lose, is it? Get us right out there underneath that limb. Come on, dinger. Ding, ding, ding. Ding for me. We're falling behind. Come on. Well, I'd like to finish in the top 50 anywho. Come on. That. Go back to the frog. I guess the best part of this event was my puppy came down and wanted petting. Mm-hmm. Thank you. All fish greatly appreciated. This is where I caught my personal best, though. But I wasn't using bottom. I didn't have them at that time. That's okay. All you can do is all you can do at whatever you try. Do the best that you can. Let the rest of it go. It'll either work or it won't. We ain't moving anywhere. Catch fish, we ain't moving anywhere. But we're catching, we caught one. Anyhow, it's better than none. One thing I wish that the results would show is who caught the biggest fish and what it was. They don't ever show that. At least I didn't figure out how to find it out. Should show somewhere. Any results. Who would think it would ever be in the results? It's a little bit bigger fish. This might be a trophy. Nope, just a regular. Just on steroids, thought it was a big fish. Or some of the gar here, a 40, 50 pound gar, they fight like they weigh 200 pounds. They don't know they ain't that big. I guess me and these people in front of me, and we still got about 7 real minutes of fishing time. Which ain't going to put us in the top 10. We might even be the bottom 10. See if anybody's catching any unis. As far as my chat goes, okay, time for another large cut. If you wonder how I'm doing that, when you press down your Z key, it'll give you your baits. And there's another key you can press down if you've got multiple rigs in a game that'll allow you to choose between those rigs, but I don't know that trick yet. I don't know what key it is. I know there's one key that gives you results with your weights and everything above it. It took me forever to figure out how to get rid of it. It was the Y key. Who'd think it's a Y? You think it's an X or something else, but a Y gets rid of it. just change rigs. I just go in the inventory and change rigs. That way I can see what I'm doing. We might not make the top 50. If I don't catch a couple more fish, we may not make the top 60. And this event goes on for another, let's see, another hour. So that'd be people do a lot better than that. And propensity done been knocked down to third. Come on, all you gotta do is catch one fish, buddy. One fish. Well, I'm not very thrilled about my performance, but it's like a man said, at least I was here. Pretty nice flathead. Let's change bait. Come over there. Let's close this one. Can't catch them if they won't keep the bait in their mouth. Ones and zeros, that's all it is. We're just about done. We got a little under 2 minutes. Not a single uni. That's pretty poor. I could post this video on how not to fish the catfish trail. That might be a way of doing it. Since I'm already here, once this is over, I may just stay and catch some gar. Well, you can just about stick a fork in me. 21 seconds. That's it, folks. That's all there is, because there ain't no more. Well, that's definitely how not to do it. That's all I can say about that. You can sell my fish. Yeah, sell my fish. Okay, what kind of weather we got here? Got a good white crappie. Two in a row. And good bass. Oh well. That's how not to do it, people.